What's up, guys, and welcome to my review for Bradley Cooper's second film, Maestro. This is the true story of Leonard Bernstein, the composer, musician, conductor, and this is a story of his life with his wife and his family. This is a love letter to their relationship. Carey Mulligan playing his wife, and this film takes place through many years, where we go from black and white, color, the aspect ratio changes. So I did really appreciate that. This movie has been getting a lot of hype, a lot of top 10 lists, and I think this movie is very good, but I don't think it's great. I think that, look, this relationship, this story that they're telling, I liked it. I thought it was good. But I've certainly seen better musical biopics before. Not saying that the directing by Bradley Cooper wasn't great, which it was. It's just the story itself. You're pulling from true life, true events. And I don't think, I mean, sure, it was interesting, I guess. But I just feel like this movie didn't wow me. It was just like, oh, okay, this is true story, and it's a very well telling of it. But by the time it ended, I thought, oh, okay, it had its emotional hooks, but I feel like the movie doesn't really hit as hard as like A Star Is Born did. The ending of A Star Is Born is very devastating. You leave the movie not feeling great. This is a little different. Where I think they could have went in that direction, they restrain from going there. And I don't know, I feel like they didn't need to be as devastating as A Star Is Born, but let's show a little, you know, of the aftermath of certain things that happened towards the end of the film. That's all I'll say without spoiling it. I thought the acting was terrific. Carey Mulligan and Bradley Cooper are phenomenal in this film, and you know, the best lead actor race is like stronger than many other years. Usually you got like two at the top and then the rest. This year you got like three strong performances that could win. I think this could go to Bradley Cooper. I think it could go to Paul Giamatti, or it could go to Cillian Murphy. I think he's fantastic in this movie as a director and as an actor. Carey Mulligan, also great. All the supporting performances, great as well. The cinematography is very energetic, especially in the first half of the movie when he's younger and there's more life in him. You really see the camera fly around and move in certain ways. That's really impressive. Really like the cinematography. And the score is from the Leonard Bernstein music, so that was nice to hear. And you know, the best parts of it for me is when Bradley Cooper is conducting the orchestra. There's a scene that takes place in like a chapel or a church when it seemed like one shot, and it's just circling around. Maybe it was a couple shots, but it felt like one shot. Where he's conducting this orchestra and he is going through it, and the emotion on his face and the pure joy of it makes you understand who this guy is without any dialogue. And I thought that those were the strongest bits of the film, where you don't necessarily hear things being said that make you feel things, but what you see makes you feel things. So I think visually, the film is very well done. This is a very well-made film. Is it a little, I don't know, long? I guess you could say the middle section of the story is, I don't want to say cliched, but it's not anything we haven't seen before, you know, where it's either Freddie Mercury or Elton John, where they get into the fame and the power, and they're out doing their own thing and drinking and doing cocaine and all that sort of thing. I mean, it's you've seen it before, and it's a similar type of tale. But I think what makes the movie special is just the bond that these two have and the love that they've grown for each other, and just kind of watching love prevail in a way, which makes it special. So in the end of the day, I really liked it. I didn't love it, but I really liked it. I feel like it's not as rewatchable as A Star Is Born. I think that film, is a better film. I do think overall it's a better film. But Cooper is giving a terrific performance in this, just as he did in A Star Is Born as well. He could have won the Oscar for that too, which he probably should have that year. I Speaking of Freddie Mercury, he did win that year, and I think he could have gone to Bradley Cooper that year as well. So, look, Maestro, like I said, it's a very good film, but not a great film. If I watch it again, maybe I'll be like, you know what, this is a great film. But as of right now, where I stand, it's not one of my favorite awards contenders this year, but it is certainly a good one. And it is a 4 out of 5 star movie for me. A very strong and solid 4, I will say that. So, guys, comment down below. Did you watch this movie? It's on Netflix now. Do you think it's going to win any of these big awards coming up? I think that the best shot it has is probably director Carey Mulligan as well for actress. But I mean, for everything we're hearing about Emma Stone and Poor Things and Lily Gladstone from Killers of Flower Moon, I'm not sure if Mulligan stands a chance, even though she is great, like terrific in this film. So who knows? It's very competitive this year. So lots of good stuff. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I've got a 4K and Blu-ray update video coming. I don't know if it's up already, but it's on the way. These two videos coming out around the same time. Also, future reviews coming out. We got Naiad. Got to check that out. It's on Netflix. Also, just hit VOD is Priscilla. Trying to check out all these awards type films, but there's also other stuff that I got to catch up on along the way. So yeah, definitely come on back for that. You can follow me on Twitter and or X at RyanKing72 and Instagram and TikTok at KingArises131. Guys, that's it for me. Thank you guys for watching my review for Maestro, and I'll see you next time. Over and out.